Trainer and Miss Orange County finalist, and this
and that there is the Tech 9, little cheap ass spray gun made out of South Miami. They retail for $380. I get them for $2, sell them for $8. They advertise this Tech 9 as the most popular gun in American crime. Can you believe that shit? It actually says that in the little booklet that comes with it. The most popular gun in American crime. Like they proud of that shit.
I love my Tech 9.
Check out this gun here. Now this here is a Steyr AUG. Steyr AUG's a bad motherfucker. Listen. That shit's expensive too, man. Made in Austria. Now my customers don't know shit about it, so there ain't no demand for it. But baby, I really could use me some more ice. Hold up. But let me tell you though, man, you put this bad boy in a flick, every motherfucker out there want one. I'm serious as a heart attack. When them Hong Kong flicks came out, every nigga in the world had to have a 45. Man, they ain't want one. They want two. Cause all them niggas want to be the killer. But what them flicks don't tell you and what they don't know, that a 45 got a serious fucking jamming problem. Now, I try to steal my customers' taller 9mm because it's damn near the same weapon and ain't got half the jamming problems. But you know how them niggas is out there. You can't tell them shit. They want a 45. The killer had a 45. They want a 45. Thanks, man.
Mm-hmm. Who's your partner?
Cat named Mr. Walker runs a fishing boat out of Mexico. I get the merchandise to him, he gets it out to my customers on all my bulk sales anyway. Before I set that nigga up, he ain't have a pot to piss in or a window to throw it out of. Now, that motherfucker rolling in cash. Got himself a yacht with all kind of high-tech navigational shit on it. Here we go. AK-47. The very best there is. When you absolutely, positively got to kill every motherfucker in the room, except no substitutes.
Nothing gets between me and my AK.
This here is the Chinese model. I get them for $850. Double my money. Grab that for me, would you, babe?
You know it's fair.
Girl, don't make me put my foot in your ass.
The AK-47 is the most popular assault rifle in the world. This is the Chinese model. You can tell by the extra rivets running
through the front. Hello, it's for you.
Yo, Jumba, what's up?
Yeah, you hanging with that stupid son kid?
Boring, isn't it?
It's your George.
Yes, he's Joe Gunn now.
Oh, I'm impressed. He seems to know a lot.
He's just repeating shit he overheard. He's any more of a gun expert than I am. You
want?
Sure. At 10 pounds, it's really heavy for such a small gun. But
to me, more. So when'd you get out of jail?
Before high school.
Where at?
Susanville.
How long?
Not 2 months shy of 4 years.
4 years? For what?
Bank robbery.
Really?
All right. Later.
Shit, I'm impressed.
See what I'm talking about? Not that. It's about a man in New York wants a 9mm Smith & Wesson model 5946. And why does he want it? Because it's the same gun that nigga on New York Undercover uses. Because of that nigga, I'm going to make $1,250 off of this nigga.
So, what's your cost?
Low as two. I'm telling you, Louis, start adding these motherfucking figures up. Tell me this ain't the business to be in. Got me 5 M60 Hello. Machine guns, too. Motherfuckers come straight out the Gulf War. I done already sold 3 of them, $20,000 apiece.
Oh, wow, that's good money.
I'm gonna make $1 million out of this, man. I already got a $500,000 sitting down in Mexico. When I deliver this next load, get me another $500,000.
Then what?
Then I'm out. spend the rest of my life spending. Well, you gonna tell me who it is?
It's Gilbert.
Don't clown me, bitch. Come on, what's up? What the fuck you doing in jail? What the fuck you doing that for? Goddamn, nigga, ain't you got better sense than be drunk driving with a goddamn pistol? Omar. Listen to me. Now, number one, you got to chill. Yeah. Of course you scared. That's what them motherfuckers get paid for. Scared the shit out of you. That's their motherfucking job.
The judge doesn't give a fuck about that. He's ready to habitualize you. Is that what you want? You want to look at 10 years? Tomorrow I'll get you out, I promise. But that means I gotta pick you up tonight. Reggie, there ain't no two ways about it. You're gonna spend the night in jail. But I already told you I'm gonna get you out tomorrow. Now, where are you? You're at your mother's, actually. Put your mother on. Miss Gilmore, this is Max Cherry. This is Reggie's. That's right, his bail bondsman. Look, Reggie is in big trouble. I want to pick him up, and I want you to be responsible for him before I sit down. Yeah, I'd like you to make sure that he's there when I get there. And look, this is second chance for him. They don't get... That's correct. All right, so I'm counting on you to help me help your son. Thank you very much. Put him back on the line, please. All right, Reggie, we're clear on this. You got it? Good. Do yourself a really big favor and be there when I get there. How can I help you?
Where can I put my ash?
Use that cup there if you like.
Oh, and I need me a bond for $10,000.
You all right out there?
Yeah.
Have some coffee? Go right ahead.
Who's that big mandingo-looking nigga you got up there on that picture with you?
That's Winston. He works here.
Damn. He's a big one, ain't he? Y'all tight?
Yeah.
But you was boss, though, right?
Yeah.
That was your idea to take that picture, too, wasn't it?
All right, you want a $10,000 bond? What have you got to put up for collateral?
Gonna have to use cash.
You have it with you?
Got it right here in my raptor bag.
You have cash. What do you need me for?
Come on, man, you know how they do. Black man show up with 10,000 cash, first thing they want to know is where I got it. Then they gonna want to keep a big chunk of it, start talking that court call shit. Fuck that noise, Jack. I go through you.
Cost you $1,000 for the bond.
I can do that.
Who's it for? Relative?
Fella named Beaumont. They got him down in county. Started out drunk driving, but they wrote it up as possession of a concealed weapon. Dumb monkey ass had a pistol on him.
10,000 sounds high.
A run his name got a hit. He been inside. Plus, he from Kentucky. And I think that kind of prejudice against brothers from down south out here.
If he runs and I have to go to Kentucky to bring him back, you pay the expenses.
You think you can do that?
Done it. What's his full name?
Beaumont, that's all I know. say that Beaumont is his first or his last name?
If I had to guess, I'd say Beaumont's his Christian name.
Records office. Hello, this is Max Cherry Bail Bonds. Who's this, please?
Yo, Del.
Hi, Vic. I need you to look away in the car. All
right, man. Cool.
Rough arrest.
We're almost done here, right?
Good now.
Yo, yo.
I need you to look up.
You check out some music while you're sitting in the car. Take the key.
Which one's for the car?
This one right here. Use that little black thing there to turn off your alarm and unlock the door.
What do I
do? You ain't got to do nothing, man. Just point it at the car, push the button, you hear a little ooh, ooh, ooh. That mean the door's unlocked and the alarm's off. Get in. Okay. Play the volume loud as you want to, but don't touch my levels now. I got them set just like I like them.
Beaumont Livingston.
Livingston, huh?
On his prior, he served 9 months. He's working on 4 years probation.
You don't say.
You know what he's on probation for?
Ain't got a clue.
Possession of unregistered machine guns.
Yeah. Now, they gonna consider that a violation of his probation?
They do consider this a violation of his probation. Your boy's looking at 10 years, plus the concealed weapon.
He ain't gonna like that. Beaumont ain't got a doing time kind of disposition.
I need your name and address.
Ordell Roby. ORDELLROBBIE. 1436 Florence Boulevard, Compton, 90222.
Is that a house or an apartment?
That's a house.
Who the fuck is this?
Sure. It's your benefactor, nigga. I'm coming up.
Come on up, nigga.
It's over.
You know, my pleasure of living demands that I have a good-looking woman, that I'm with a good-looking woman. I couldn't go out with a woman old enough to be my wife.
Oh, D!
Look at you and your free ass.
What's up, man?
Hey, no, you boy. Give me a motherfucking hug.
I know you was coming back.
Yeah. My nigga.
Looking out, man. I don't know what to say, man. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Who was there for your ass,
you
huh?
You was there
who?
For
you.
Who? You,
who?
Nigga, you.
You goddamn right, see? That's how that shit works. You get your ass in trouble, I get your ass out. That's my motherfucking job. And I don't mind telling you, nigga, it's steady work.
Hey, look here, man. I'm still scared to the motherfucker OD. They talking like they serious as hell. Give me time for that machine gun shit.
Oh, come on, man. They just trying to put a fright in your ass.
If that's what they doing, they done did it.
How old is that machine gun shit, huh?
About 3 years.
3 years? Come on, man. That's an old crime, man. They ain't got room in the joint for all these niggas out here killing people now. How they gonna find room for you?
Ain't what they telling me.
That's why they call that fucking with you. Now let me tell you how we gonna retaliate, all right? Tomorrow, I'm gonna pick you up, take you over to Century City, introduce you to my lawyer. Now let me tell you something about my lawyer. This brother's name is Stassen Goins, and this nigga is a junkyard dog. He my own personal Johnny Cochran. Matter of fact, he kicked Johnny Cochran's ass. And like Johnny Cochran, this nigga hate cops. I'm serious, man. He lived to fuck with the police. Now, as a favor, I had him look at your case. And he said, you ain't got shit to worry about. They just fucking with you. So we gonna sick the junkyard dog on their ass and make them stop fucking with you.
Huh? He looking out, man. Huh? Good looking out. Come on in, man.
No, come on, man.
Let's celebrate.
Look, I'm really supposed to be somewhere. Matter of fact, I was kind of hoping you could run with me.
What you mean?
You know, man, I hate to be the kind of nigga that do a nigga a favor and then bam, hit the nigga up for a favor in return, but I got to be that kind of nigga.
What?
I need a favor, nigga.
That requires me to go out tonight?
Just a bit.
Oh, man, I wasn't planning on going no place tonight, man. It's late as hell, man. I'm home, I'm high, man. Come on.
And why are you home, huh? You home because I spent $10,000 to get your ass home. Now look, I got a little problem, all right? I need some help. You can help me out. Now come on, go on in the house, throw some shit on. Come on, let's walk out to the car with you. Come on.
Ready, man. What's the problem?
There ain't no problem, man. It's more like a situation. You remember them three M60 machine guns I sold last year at the five I got?
Yeah.
I almost sell the other two tonight. There's this group of Koreans over in Koreatown starting this little neighborhood watch thing, and they need some weapons so they can show the neighborhood niggas they need business. Now, I'm gonna sell them the other two machine guns, all right? Problem is, I ain't never done business with these Koreans before. And I ain't worried, because by and large, Asians are very dependable. You know, they don't want no trouble. And you might argue with them about price and shit, but you ain't got to worry about them shooting in the back, you know what I'm saying? But I got me a rule. Never do business with people you ain't never done business with before without backup. And that's why I need you. Backup. Now look, all you got to do is lay in here and hold on to this one. All right? I'm going to tell them I'm going in the trunk to show them the goods. When I open the trunk, you pop up and rack this motherfucker.
Man, fuck that shit. I ain't finna shoot nobody.
I ain't saying nothing about you shooting nobody. All you got to do is hold on to it. They'll get the idea.
Man, you must be out of your fucking mind if you think I'm finna get in this dirty-ass trunk.
We ain't going nowhere but to Koreatown, man. You ain't going to be in here no more than 10 minutes.
Man, I ain't riding in no goddamn trunk for no minute, man. Why I can't ride up front with you?
You can't ride up front with me. The surprise element is 90% of it.
I'm sorry, man, but I ain't getting no goddamn trunk.
I can't believe you do me like this.
Do you like what, man? I just ain't climbing in no goddamn dirty-ass trunk, man. I got a problem with small places, no.
Well, I got a problem with spending $10,000 on ungrateful peanut-head niggas to get them out of jail, but I did it. And how small was that jail cell, motherfucker?
Look, man, I know I owe you. You got to bring all this
up. If you owe me, then get your ass in this trunk.
Man, I want to help you, but I won't be locked in no goddamn trunk or no car.
You think I want to spend $10,000 on your ass, huh?
Man, I know.
Do you think I wanted to spend $10,000 on your ass?
Of course you didn't, man, but you nigga in the trunk.
But that's the only way I could help you, right? So that's what I did. Now, look, man. All I'm asking you to do is get in the trunk, hold this fucking shotgun, and point it at these over heads when I open it.
You catch your nigga off guard with this shit.
Look here. I tell you what. When we get through fucking with these Koreans, me and you go to Roscoe Chicken and Waffle on me. Think about it now. That Skull Special, smothered in gravy and onions, cider, red beans and rice, some greens.
Man. Exactly how long I gotta be in this motherfucker? Hey, you said 10 minutes.
Thank you. Okay, hold on. Louis, babe, it's so dead. Oh, I'm just gonna go pee.
Well, Louis, my man, what you doing?
Okay, I'm just hanging out with Simone.
Oh, yeah? She doing that show for you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear the Supremes in the background. She ain't bad, is she?
Nah, she's pretty good.
She do Mary Wells for you yet?
Nah, I don't know the names of everybody, but she done a whole bunch of them.
Uh-huh. Well, guess where I am?
I don't know.
I'm in the cozy confines of an Oldsmobile parked right outside Simone's house.
Oh, you outside?
Yeah.
Come on in.
No, man. I not really caught that show. I got some for your eyes only shit to show you. Why don't you step outside?
Who's that?
That's Beaumont.
Who's Beaumont?
An employee I had to let go.
What did he do?
He put himself in a position where he was gonna have to do 10 years in prison. That's what he did. If you know Beaumont, you know ain't no goddamn way he can do 10 years. If you know that, then you know Beaumont's gonna do anything Beaumont can to keep from doing them 10 years, including telling the federal government any and every motherfucking thing about my black ass. Now that, my friend, is a clear-cut case of him or me. And you best believe it ain't gonna be me. Now, Louis? If you gonna come in on this thing with me, you got to be prepared to go all the way. Now, I got me so far $500,000 in lockboxes in a bank down in Cabo San Lucas. I make this delivery, I'm gonna have me over a million. Hey, you think I'm gonna let a little cheese-eating nigga like this fuck that up? Man, you best think again. Before I let that happen, I'll shoot this nigga in the head and 10 niggas look just like him. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we on the same page then?
Yeah, I follow.
My nigga.
Detective Mark Gargis, LAPD. Can I ask what you have in that bag?
The usual stuff. You know, I'm a flight attendant for Cabo Air.
Can I help out here?
Who's this?
Sorry, this is Special Agent Ray Nicolette with alcohol, tobacco, and firearms.
Oh, really? May I see some ID?
Yeah, sure. Would you mind if we just took a look in that bag?
Do I mind? Do I have a choice?
You have the right to say no?
No.
And I have the right to make you wait here with Ray while I go get a warrant. If I don't want to go to all that trouble, I'll just take you on suspicion right now.
Suspicion of what?
Can I say something? He just wants to peek inside the bag for a minute. I'll keep my eye on so he doesn't take anything.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks a lot. Oh. Bad knees. Got a good flight? It's a shitty flight down to Cabo. I went down there one time with Susan, my wife. Fucking turbulence was unbelievable. Hey, can I look in this envelope? $50,000 here. What would you say, Ray?
Looks like about $50,000 from here.
This your money?
What if I say no?
Well, you should know if you bring in anything over $10,000, you have to declare it. You forget or what? You could get a $250,000 fine plus 2 years in prison. Now, you want to talk to us about this, or do you want to talk to Customs?
I'm not saying another word.
Jackie. I hope you don't mind if I call you Jackie. Those guys down in Customs, they're a bunch of fucking pricks. Excuse me, but they are. I know there's something about that job just makes those people really hard to get along with. Now, you can go down and you can talk with those guys who are really suspicious and just really disagreeable human beings, or you can talk with a couple of good-hearted guys like Mark and myself. It's up to you.
So let's take a look here at the file on Jacqueline Brown. According to this, this isn't the first time that you've run afoul of the law. 1985, while a stewardess for Delta, you were busted while carrying drugs for a pilot?
The pilot was my husband and I got off.
You mean they offered you a deal and you grabbed it? He did time, you did probation. I didn't hear you ask permission to smoke in my office.
May I smoke?
No, you may not. So, you get off with a slap on the wrist, but all this criminal activity fucks up your shit for good with the big airlines. Cut to 13 years later, you're 44 years of age, you're flying for the shittiest little shuttle fucking piece of shit Mexican airline that there is. Well, you make what, $13,000 a year?
I make $16,000 plus benefits.
You've been in the service industry 19 years and all you make is 16,000 plus benefits? Didn't exactly set the world on fire, did you, Jackie?
Jack, you're a good lawyer.
Can she afford a good one's more like it? Otherwise, you'll be in civil brand 3 weeks before the public defender gets around to you.
Hey, Jackie, do you know a guy named Beaumont Langston? Yeah? No? Because he knows you. Well, he knew you. He didn't know anybody now. He's dead. They found him in the trunk of a car this morning. Shot. Twice. Once in the chest. Once in the head. There you go. So I guess I'm wondering, if you don't know Beaumont, why do you suppose Beaumont knows you?
Look, Miss Brown, we don't give a fuck about you. You know who we want. If you cooperate, you tell us what we want to know, we'll help you get out of this. And if you refuse to cooperate and you continue to cop a shit attitude like you're doing now, we will give you to customs and they will take you to court. And with your prior, the judge will give you 2 years. Now, you'll probably only end up serving a year and some change, but if I was a 44-year-old black woman desperately clinging on to this one shitty little job that I was fortunate enough to get, I don't think that I'd think I had a year to throw away. So let's start again now, shall we? Who in Mexico gave you this money, and who in America were you bringing it to?
I'm not saying another goddamn word.
I'd like your permission to look through this again so we'll know exactly how much we're talking about here.
Sure, go ahead.
All right, let's see what else is in there. You mind?
Beauty case.
Mm-hmm. What's in it?
Beauty products. Alarm clock. Glass case. Birth control.
What's that?
My diet shit.
Let's see what else is in there.
Here.
What's this?
What's that shit?
Go, lady. Sneak it in. First door on the left.
99 years is a long, long, long time. 99 years is such a long, long, long time. 99 years is a long, long time. Well, look at me, I'll never be free. I'm a long time woman.
Brown, case 70032. Charge is possession of narcotics with the intent to distribute. How did your client plead?
Your Honor, she wishes to stand mute.
Very well. Detective Varga.
Dargis, Your Honor.
Sorry. You are the arresting officer in this case?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And do you have a bail recommendation?
Yes, I do, Your Honor.
That would be?
Based on the defendant's prior conviction and the extreme possibility of flight due to the occupation, the state requests a bond of no less than $25,000.
And the people are fine with this? I'm gonna set bond at 10,000 and set the date of August 21st for the treatment.
Your Honor, when will that be?
That's 6 weeks from now, Miss Brown. We'll continue this matter then. Owens, case 72242. Charges possession of a concealed weapon and striking an officer. How does your client?
I thought it'd be 25. Absolutely, man.
My client would like to plead guilty.
Arresting officer here in the court.
Your hands. Comfortable? Yeah, doors open, so I just come on in.
I can see that.
Why? Got some more business for you.
Yeah?
What'd he do? She is an airline stewardess. Got caught coming back from Mexico with some blow. They set a bond this afternoon at $10,000. Now I'm figuring you can take that $10,000 you owe me from Beaumont, move it over to the stewardess.
The bond for possession is only
$1,000. Yeah, man, they fucking with her. They calling that shit possession with intent. A 44-year-old black woman caught with less than 2 ounces, they call that shit intent. The same thing happened to a movie star. They call it possession.
Still sounds high.
Well, she had on, I believe it was, $50,000 in cash.
All right, before we start talking about stewardesses, let's get Beaumont out of the way first.
You know, I think somebody already did.
What?
You ain't hear?
Hear what?
Somebody with a grudge blew Beaumont's brains out. Oh, shit. That shit rhymed. Blew Beaumont's brains out.
Police made contact with you?
Oh, hell yeah. First motherfucking thing they did. You know, they see I pay a big money bond for my boy. They start thinking with that wet-ass, smoked-ass fire logic. You know, routed my ass out of bed 10 o'clock in the morning. Scared the shit out of my woman, Sharonda. She thought they was gonna take my ass away for sure.
The stewardess, you know her last name?
Mm-hmm. Brown. Jackie Brown.
What does she do for you?
Who says she do anything for me? She my friend. My friends get in trouble, I like to help them out.
Beaumont work for you?
This you and me talking, you know, like lawyer client thing, and you can't tell nothing I say to you?
You're not my client till you get busted and I bind you out.
Well, we ain't got no, what you call that shit? Confidentiality. Why should I tell you anything?
Because you want me to know what a slick guy you are. You got stewardesses bringing you $50,000.
And why would a stewardess be bringing me $50,000?
Now you want me to speculate on what you do. I'd say you're in the drug business, except the money's moving in the wrong direction. Whatever you're into, you seem to be getting away with it, so more power to you. All right. You want another bond? You want to move the $10,000 you got on Beaumont over to the stewardess? That means paperwork. I got to get a death certificate, present it to the court, make out a receipt for return of bond collateral. Type up another application.
Hey, man, Jackie ain't got time for all that shit.
Look, I'm telling you what I have to do. What you have to do, in case you forgot, is come up with a premium of $1,000.
I can do that. You know I got the money. I just ain't got it with me.
Come back when you do. I'll bond out the stewardess.
You got to look at this with a little compassion, all right? Jackie ain't no criminal. She ain't used to this kind of treatment.
Now, gangsters, they don't give a fuck. But you know, your average citizen, a couple of nights in county, get to fucking with their mind.
Ordell, this isn't a bar. You don't have a tab.
Listen to me, all right? You got a 44-year-old, gainfully employed black woman, falsely accused.
Falsely accused? She didn't come back from Mexico with cocaine on her?
Falsely accused of intent? Now, if she had that shit, and mind you, I'm saying if, that was her own personal shit to get high with.
Is white guilt supposed to make me forget I'm running a business?
Like that, huh? Alright. I got you $1,000.
Hey, Candy.
Hey, Max.
Dropping off Lopez, Anita, picking up Brown, Jackie.
Okay, no problem. You armed?
You bet I am. Well, who do you think I am? I showed you my card in there.
Can I see your ID?
You serious?
Who paid my bond? Redell?
In cash.
Oh.
got any cigarettes in here.
You won't find any cigarettes in there.
Can we stop and get cigarettes?
Sure. You ever been to the river bottom?
I don't think so.
It's all right. It's a cop bar.
Can we just stop at a 7-Eleven or something?
Thought you might like to have a drink.
I'd love to have a drink, but not there.
How about the Hilton by the airport?
Is it dark?
Kind of a sports bar.
It doesn't sound dark.
Why does it have to be dark?
Because it looks like I just got out of jail, that's why. Look, you're dropping me off at my place. There's a joint near me.
No, thanks. I quit 3 years ago.
Gain weight?
10 pounds. I take that off and put it back on.
That's why I don't quit. I can't fly. I'm gonna have a bitch of a time trying to find my brand.
You know, the other day I figured out that I must have written about 15,000 bonds since I've been in the business. I figure about 80% of those were at least drug related. So if you want, I could help you figure out your options.
So far, they told me if I cooperate, then I'll get probation, maybe. Or if I stand mute, I can get as much as 5 years. Does that sound right?
I'd say that if they try you and convict you, you won't get more than a year and a day. Now, that's state time, prison. But they won't want to do that. They'll offer you simple possession, a couple of months of county time, and a year or two of probation. Do you happen to know who put the dope in your bag?
Yeah. But that's not what this is about. They were waiting for my ass. They knew about the money. They even knew the exact amount.
What did they want to know?
Who gave him the money and who I was giving it to. And they found this guy in the trunk of a car with his head blown off. They said it was him who told him about me.
That would be Omar Livingston.
How do you know about him?
I wrote him on Monday. They found him dead on Tuesday.
Where'd they pick up his bond?
Same as you. $10,000.
Back about 18 and 25, I left Tennessee very much alive.
Thanks, Jerry.
You're welcome.
So we are in five.
Good luck. We'll be in touch.
Had some trouble with my sweetheart's paw. One of her brothers was a bad outlaw. I wrote a letter to my Uncle Fudd, and I rode away on a Tennessee stud. The Tennessee stud was long and lean, the color of the sun, and his eyes were green. He had the nerve and he had the blood. There never was a horse like.
How you doing, Miss Jack?
Come on in.
You got some booze?
I got some vodka in the freezer.
Got some OJ? Well, why don't you be a good hostess and hook a brother up a screwdriver?
Sure.
Well, you gonna thank me?
For what?
Who the hell you think got your ass out of jail?
The same guy that put my ass in jail. Thanks a lot.
Hey, you got caught with blow. That's your business.
It wasn't mine.
What? Oh, shit. I bet that was that present Mr. Walker was sending Melanie. Yeah. If you didn't put it in there, he must have. Damn. That shit worth calling for, baby. I'm sorry. Got to ask you a whole shitload of questions about it, huh? And all that money, where it came from. Probably asked you who you was bringing it to, too.
They asked.
And you said?
I want to talk to my lawyer.
You sure you didn't get nervous and let something slip? I mean, if you did, you know, I ain't mad at you. I just gotta know.
You ain't asking the right questions. You should be asking why they picked me up. They were waiting for me. They knew about the money, and they knew the exact amount.
They, tell you how they happened to come by this information?
Beaumont Livingston?
I knew it. I knew it.
They even asked me if I knew Mr. Walker.
Yeah?
I didn't tell him anything about it.
My name come up? You ain't say nothing about me. Mm-mm. All right, that's mighty noble of you. They tell you what happened to this Beaumont fella?
Yeah, they told me.
Yeah. Somebody must have been real mad at old Beaumont. Else they're pretty scared about what he might say to keep him doing some time. Yeah, I bet they asked you a whole shitload of questions. And you ain't giving me no kind of answer. You scared of me? You got any reason to be nervous around me? Is that what I think it is?
What do you think it is?
I think it's a gun pressed up against my dick.
Well, you thought right. Now take your hands from around my throat, nigga.
What the hell's wrong with you, Jackie?
Shut the fuck up and don't you move. Oh, what is this? What the fuck is
Hey, now that ain't got nothing to do with you. I carry that all the time. You been talking to them police too much.
Oh, the police didn't try and strangle my ass.
Oh, come on, girl. You know I was just playing with you.
Well, I ain't playing with you.
I'ma unload both of these motherfuckers if you don't do what I tell you to do. You understand what I'm saying?
Jackie, stop acting crazy.
Do you understand what the fuck I'm saying?
You're a woman, damn.
Now sit your ass down on that sofa.
See? Police start fucking with your mind. Start pitting black against black. That's how they do. You know, been doing it since the beginning.
Shut your raggedy ass up and sit the fuck down. And put your hands behind your head.
Come on, it's getting silly now.
Oh, silly? You want to see some motherfucking silly? If I have to tell you to shut up one more time, I'm going to shut you up.
I just came over here to talk to you.
To talk? The way I see it, you and me got one motherfucking thing to talk about. One thing. And that's what you are willing to do for me.
And get your lawyer.
No, let's be realistic. Now, sooner or later, they're gonna get around to offering me a plea deal, and you know that. That's why you came here to kill me.
They ain't come over here to kill you.
Hey, it's okay. Now, I forgive you. Now, let's say, if I tell on you, I walk. If I don't, I go to jail.
Uh-huh.
I want $100,000 in an escrow account in my name if I'm convicted up to a year or put on probation. Now, if I have to do more than a year, you pay another $100,000.
I can do that. But you know I got that problem, and all my money is
in Mexico.
Right.
Well, I've been thinking about that, too. And I got me an idea.
Well, let me hear that. If we friends again, you can point that motherfucking gun somewhere else.
I'll talk to the cops tomorrow and tell you if it's on.
All right.
You want your gun back? Come on in, I'll get it for you. Max, I am so sorry about this. You know, I was afraid to ask to borrow it. Because I was afraid you would say no. I mean, you'd have to. Would you like some coffee?
If you're having some?
I am. Come on in. Why don't you make yourself at home? You know, have a seat.
You get a chance to use it?
Oh, I felt a lot safer having it. Oh, the milk went bad while I was in jail.
Black's fine.
Cool.
Would you care to hang on to it for a while? It wouldn't be legal, but if it makes you feel better, I guess.
Well, thanks. I got one now.
You went out this morning and bought a gun?
What? I didn't hear you.
You went out this morning and bought a gun?
Well, let's say I got one now, okay?
Somebody loan it to you?
Yeah. All right. We're on. Might be a little black. Would you like to hear some music?
Sure.
Cool.
You know, I couldn't wait to get home last night and wash the gel out of my hair.
Looks nice.
Thanks.
You never got into the whole CD revolution?
Oh, I got a few. But I can't afford to start all over again. I mean, I've invested too much time and money in my albums.
Yeah, but you can't get new stuff on records.
I don't get new stuff at all. Sick today. As far as the airline knows, I'm still available.
Are you?
I don't know. I'm going to talk with Nicolette and Darius today. I'm going to do what you suggested. Offer to help and see what happens.
What I meant was to have a lawyer do the negotiating for you.
No, I want to talk to them first. I know more now about Ordell's money.
Well, if it's the ATF guy that wants you, that'll only interest him up to a point.
Oh, but it's a lot of money. It's $500,000 all in Kabul. And more coming in.
How'd you find that out?
Ordell told me last night.
He called?
He came by.
What'd you do?
We talked.
Do you think he still trusts you?
He had his doubts at first, but he's always trusted. He wants to believe more than anything else that he still can.
Why?
Because he needs my ass. Otherwise, that money's just gonna sit over there in Kabul. Want some sugar?
No, thanks. There's gotta be other ways of getting it out.
Maybe, but I'm the only one he's ever used. I mean, he can't use his other people. They're crooks. I mean, he might try to bring the money in himself, but he ain't gonna want to stand in no customs lines. So either he recruits another Kabul stewardess or he continues to trust me, and I made him feel like he still can.
Are you gonna offer to set him up?
Yeah, if I get off. Otherwise, fuck him.
It's very possible that Ordell's killed somebody. You realize that?
Well, I ain't going back to jail, and I ain't doing that probation thing again. Max, how do you feel about getting old?
You're not old. You look great.
No, I'm asking you, how do you feel about getting old? Doesn't it bother you?
It's not really something I think about.
Really?
Oh, I guess I got a little sensitive about my hair a few years ago. Started falling out, so, you know, I did something about it.
How'd you feel about that?
I feel fine with it. Otherwise, I wouldn't have done it. I did it to feel better about myself, and, you know, I do. I look in the mirror, looks like me.
Yeah, but it's different for men.
You know, I can't really feel too sorry for you in this department. I'd bet that except for possibly an afro, you look exactly the way you did at 29.
Well, my ass ain't the same.
Bigger?
Yeah.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. Something else worry you?
I always feel like I'm starting over.
How many bonds you said you wrote?
15,000.
Is that a lot?
It's plenty.
Well, I've flown over 7 million miles and I've been waiting on people for 20 years. And after my bust, the best job I could get was with Cabo Air, which is the worst job you could get in this industry. You know, I make $16,000 a year plus retirement benefits that ain't worth a damn. And with this arrest hanging over my head, man, I'm scared. And if I lose this job, I gotta start all over again, and I ain't got nothing to start over with. I'll be stuck with whatever I can get. And that shit is more scary than Ordell.
Hey, great you're here.
Yeah. Hey, Jackie, how you doing?
Hi.
Can I have a word outside with Ray for a minute?
Oh, sure. Take your time.
Send you a few minutes.
Okay, may I smoke?
Absolutely.
Let's
make a deal.
Oh, yeah? She's not scared?
Yeah, she almost sounds scared.
What's she want?
She wants to go back to work.
Oh, yeah? So what's she going to give us?
She hasn't gone into specifics yet. She's been waiting for you to get here.
She knows it's my kids, right?
Well, she hasn't said it, but she's not stupid.
She knows
it's you who wants her.
Let's go.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Now,
what can we do for you?
I need permission to leave the country so I can keep my job.
Yeah. You look into that?
I need it tomorrow. If I don't show up for work tomorrow, I'm fired.
Well, you know what we want.
If I'm working, I can help you.
Help us do what, Jackie?
Help you get Ordell Roby.
So now you do know him.
You never asked if I did or not.
You're telling us now that you do know him.
Of course I do. I deliver money for him.
Oh, shit. You know how he makes his money?
He sells guns.
You ever seen him sell a gun?
No.
How do you know he sells guns?
He told me. Besides, why else would an ATF man be after him?
Well, how can you help us?
Well, hey, I'll do anything I can to help you get his ass. Short of wearing a wire. And in return for my help, I need permission to leave the country.
Because he betrayed Nani Vitale. Read the paper. Read it. What? Nani Vitale, the dangerous criminal. He's already killed 2 people. You know what he's known as? The Mad Dog Murderer. You afraid?
Hey, girl.
Looks like somebody got some new clothes.
Yeah, we did a little shopping. You know, I couldn't have my boy run around looking like no bum.
I didn't look like a bum.
Oh, come on now. Man, you know you had that Salvation Army thing going.
Damn, girl. You getting high already? It's just 2 o'clock.
It's that late.
You know, you smoke too much of that shit. That shit's gonna rob you of your ambition.
Not if your ambition is to get high and watch TV.
Oh, y'all a couple of Cheech and Chongs, huh? Well, don't get up. I got it.
Have a seat.
Yo, Jackie, what's up?
No, Jackie, I didn't get your message.
I was gonna tell you.
No, not on the phone. You gotta make sure anybody follows.
Ready to go?
Yeah, there's another bullet. Take your thumb off the car. Up the capillaries, you know, when you cough, you're pulling air, or in this case, smoke, into parts of the lungs that don't normally get used, and so coughing's good, it gets you higher.
You definitely know a lot about that. Look here, look, I got to run out for a little while, so, if you like getting high so much, why don't you hang out here with me, I'll watch a little TV. Wherever. See, I get high later on when I come back. See, I get high at night. When I get through with all my business. Is that right?
No, it's Helmet Burger.
Why don't you walk me to the adult space, girl? I hope you don't mind hanging out with Lewis. Try not to tear his clothes off. Now, Lewis, catch you later, man.
Okay, later.
Want a metrics?
Damn. What's a metric?
It's like this major meal that you drink in a shake instead of having a big meal.
It's like a diet thing?
No, it's what bodybuilders drink to beef up. Okay. When was the last time I saw you?
6-7 years ago.
Doesn't seem like that long ago.
It was that long ago. How old were you in this picture?
Which one?
Roll a disco picture. This one.
Oh, 14.
You 14?
Yep.
Shit. I thought you were at least 16.
Yeah. About the same height now as I was then. Picture, that green one?
Yeah.
That was taken at that place called Flippers. Remember that? It was in Hollywood. Were you in L.A. then?
No.
Where were you?
I was in Detroit.
With Ordell?
Yeah, we've done some time already.
Were you a disco guy?
Yeah.
Come on, don't lie.
No, I wasn't. I don't like to dance.
Oh. Were you ever in one?
Well, I went to a few just to meet women, but it's so loud. And I don't like to dance. And during that whole scene, I just drank in bars usually. So we didn't make the cut. Mm.
Well, that's a picture of me in Japan.
Whose arm is that?
That's the guy that I live with. His name was Hiroshi.
Well, it must have made quite an impression.
Count cheese. I never got to know him, really. You know, I couldn't speak any Japanese, and his English was terrible. But, you know, what am I going to say? His English is better than my Japanese, you know.
Sounds like a problem.
Not really. I mean, we didn't have that much to say to each other anyway. I never really got to know him, but I knew enough to know that I wasn't missing much, so. Anyway, I keep that picture because of all the fucking time I was there. That's the only picture I've got of me in Japan. That's Japan.
Oh, yeah, well, I could, yeah, it looks, I could tell.
Wanna fuck?
Yeah. Got a beer?
Yeah, sure, in the fridge.
From your crib, 10 minutes from the gig.
What's your drink, brother?
Let me get a screwdriver on.
How you doing?
Oh, I'm fine.
Yes, you are. Damn, I bet you come in here on a Saturday night, you need nigger repellent to keep them motherfuckers off your ass.
Oh, I do okay.
Bullshit, Jackie. You a fine motherfucker. I bet you do a damn sight better than okay. You think anybody followed you?
I don't think so. But it don't matter because they already know I'm meeting you.
How the fuck they know that?
I told them.
You told them 325. Keep it.
Thank you, sir.
You told them? You told them it's me?
They already know it's you.
Goddamn, that don't mean you got to confirm it.
Look, the only way they're going to give me permission to fly is if I agree to help them, which is what I have to appear to be doing. So I might as well give them somebody they already know. You.
You tell them anything else?
Yeah, you got a half a meal in Mexico and you want me to bring it in.
You told them all that?
It's true, ain't it?
What the fuck that got to do with anything?
They know I'm delivering for you. I told them about the half. Now they could give a fuck about it. All they want to do is catch your ass with guns. So I said, look, you want proof he's getting paid for selling them? Let me bring in the money.
And they said?
Yes. What's the matter? I mean, that's what we discussed last night.
You know, this shit seemed kind of risky now, you know?
Now let me lay it all out to you, okay? I make two deliveries. The first, the 10,000, you know, like a dry run. Then watch it, see how it works.
And the second delivery, I come in with a half mil.
See, that's too much exposure. I ain't going nowhere near that money.
You don't have to. I told him you never pick up the money yourself. You always send someone, and I never know who it is.
That's a good idea.
If you listen, it's a damn good idea. Now, the first time I do it, they're looking around. They see me hand the $10,000 to someone.
Who?
I don't know, a friend of yours.
Like a woman?
If you want.
Yeah, I'm thinking a woman. Wait a minute. If they're gonna let you go, how come we don't bring all the cash in the first time?
Because I don't trust him. Now, the next trip, when I bring in the half mils, it's gonna look like I'm doing the same thing as I did before.
But you don't?
No, I hand it to someone else first.
And they follow the wrong one, thinking she bringing the money to me.
Hey, that's the idea.
So we gonna need two women.
Can you cover that?
Yeah, I got the women covered. Where you plan on pulling this off?
The Delamo Mall, the food court.
And I suppose you see a piece of this for yourself.
It's my plan. We're in this together.
Yeah, but it's my money and I don't need no fucking partners.
Ain't your partner. I'm your manager. And I'm managing to get your money out of Mexico into America in your hands. And I'm managing to do it all under the nose of the cops. So therefore, I'm your manager and a manager gets 15%.
No, manager get 10%.
No, that's an agent. A manager gets
10.
No. A manager gets 15%. Agent gets 10. I'm getting 15%. All right?
All I'm going to give you is 10.
And the same deal as before.
I can do that.
So he says, fuck that, and moves over into guns. So you can sell guns wherever there's a demand, and nobody gives a shit. He's acting like he's this big international arms dealer when, I mean, come on, face it. The only people I ever sold to were dopers.
Yeah, well, he seems to be making out.
Good?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, so far he is. But you gotta admit, he's not too bright.
Oh, I wouldn't go so far as to say that.
He moves his lips when he reads. What does that tell you? Okay, let's say that he's streetwise, you know? We'll give him that. He's still a fuck up. Killed a man who worked for him the other day.
Well, so what are you trying to tell me? Thought you'd get out of here?
That's not what I'm saying at all. You know where he went? He went to go meet that stewardess.
Is that Polly?
Please.
Well, I don't know. You live with him, so...
No, I live here. He just drops in and out. Did he tell you about that half million he's got down in Mexico?
No.
Yeah, well, of course he did. He tells anybody he's gonna listen. Well, that's what him and that stewardess are doing. They're scheming on how they can get the money over here.
And your point is...
Let him and the stewardess get the money over here.
Uh-huh.
And then just take it from them.
Can I ask you a question?
Oh, man. Come on, you ain't gonna get serious on me while we're in here chilling, now, is you?
No, it's just about Melanie.
Oh, you know what? I'm real sorry about that, man, but I had to be somewhere all of a sudden. I figured, oh, shit, Lewis ain't had no pussy for a while, so I thought I'd let him kick it in with Mel.
So what she say?
Man, she ain't have to say shit. I know Melanie. That bitch gonna be fucking you 2 minutes after I'm out the door. Melanie real good about throwing the fucking niggas away. Man, she ain't no damn good at it, but she likes to fuck.
No, so she ain't your girlfriend.
Is that what you thought?
No, I wasn't sure. No.
But you fucked her anyway, though, huh?
Well, the not your girlfriend part I felt more about.
Well, I hope you felt appropriately guilty afterwards.
Afterwards, I do. What is she to you?
You know, she just one of the bitches I got set up. I got Mel over in Hermosa Beach, and I rent this little place for Simone over in Compton, where you stay. And about 4 blocks away, I got this young 19-year-old country girl named Sharonda. I found her on the bus stop 2 days out of Georgia, barefoot, country as a chicken coop. Took her to my place in Compton, told her it was Hollywood.
She believed you?
Hell yeah. Her dumb country ass Compton is Hollywood. Closest she ever been anyway.
But you trust Melanie around your business?
She trying to play your ass against me, ain't she?
Yeah.
I knew it. See, you ain't have to say nothing. I know that bitch.
No, I don't understand why you keep someone around your business and you can't even trust them.
I ain't gotta trust her. I know her.
I don't know what that means, man.
Well, you can't trust Melanie, but you can always trust Melanie to be Melanie.
Well, I don't understand why you keep them the fuck around.
I told you, man, she my fine little surfer gal. You know, she ain't pretty as she used to be, and she bitch a whole lot more than she used to. But she white.
Jackie, it's Max. I was just calling to find out how everything went today at ATF. If you want to call me, my home number is 915-9302. Or you can reach me at my office, which is 313-3688. That's on the card I gave you when we first met. I don't know whether you still have it, but it's on it. Oh, let me give you my deeper number. It's 991-1075. Then dial 6872. Wait for a beep. Dial 59 and hit the pound. Okay, so I'll talk to you later. Hope everything's well. Bye-bye.
And your message.
Now the money's gonna be in the Del Amo shopping bag, all right? I get some food, sit down here in the food court. Then your girl comes in. Oh, did you find somebody yet?
Mm-hmm.
Who?
Don't you care?
Well, I care. It's my ass facing the penitentiary. You sent some hard-headed rock hoe up in here.
Hey, she ain't gonna be no rock hoe. It's gonna be cool. Promise. Just catching a movie.
What'd you see?
What the fuck is up with this shit? I called you last night.
I know, I got your message. Ray wanted to have dinner with me so we can, you know, talk about the sting we're plotting. That's what he calls it, a sting. He's been real nice.
You think he's got a thing for you?
Maybe. But I'm thinking it's something more like he wants the money for himself.
Has he hinted around?
No. Just tries to act cool.
You know, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. He's just a young guy having fun being a cop. I know the type, trust me on this. He's more interested in Ordell than he is in the money. If he does anything suspect, it'll be cutting corners to get the conviction, but he wouldn't walk off with the money. It's evidence.
And what about you, Matt?
I was in Nicolette's place?
No, I mean you right now. Not if you were somebody else.
If I saw an opportunity to walk away with a shopping bag full of money, would I take it?
Well, you know where it came from. It's not like it's somebody's life savings. You wouldn't even be missed.
$500,000 will always be missed.
You're avoiding the question.
Okay, sure, I guess I'd be tempted. Especially now since I'm getting out of the bail bond business.
Why?
A lot of reasons. I guess the main one would be, I'm tired of it.
When did you decide?
Been a long time coming, but, finally made up my mind. I guess it was Thursday. Brown?
Yes?
I'm Max Cherry, your bail bondsman.
The night you got me out of jail?
Yeah. I went to pick up this guy. I hear he's staying at a house, and I
sneak in, and I'm waiting for him.
Oh, wait a minute. After we were together, you snuck into a guy's house?
Yeah. Went back to my office and found out that you took my gun, got another gun and the stun gun, went to this guy's house in El Monte and waited for him to come home.
What do you do when he comes home?
Shoot him with the stun gun. While he's incapacitated, you cuff him and take him to county.
You do that?
It's my job.
Did you do that that night?
Well, the guy never came home. But I'm sitting on his couch, in the dark, holding my stun gun. Whole house smells of cat pee. And after a couple of hours, I think, what am I doing this? 19 years of this shit, and I make up my mind. That's it.
I'm not sure you answered my question, Max.
Which one?
If you had the chance, unemployed now, to walk away with $500,000, would you take it?
How's your flight?
Fine.
Bet you happy to be working again.
Yeah.
Say TFA, Ray, Nicolette, Jackie Brown, Ordell, Robbie, Money Exchange, Toronto. Time is 3:07, July 1st, 1995. Location is parking structure LAX, row F, parking structure D.
What are you doing?
Recording all this.
I thought you were gonna let this one go through.
We are, don't worry about it.
Every bit of this goes in my report. The subject is carrying a flight bag. I am now removed from the flight bag a manila envelope. The envelope contains currency. All the same denomination? $100 bills. Okay, I'm not counting it.
What time do you have to be there?
4:30 and meet me, woman.
What's your name?
You wouldn't say. You gonna follow her?
She leaves somebody behind her.
You're not gonna stop her.
Okay. The total amount of cash in the manila envelope is $10,000, right? The subject is delivering currency in a
Delamo Fashion Center bag.
Delamo Fashion Center bag. Bag is purple.
White.
It's
white.
Fine, the bag's
pink
white.
Letter.
The image is a purple. Lettering's pink.
Okay, the bag's white, it's got purple on it, and the lettering's pink.
Great.
With a really good-looking woman on the cover. Okay, there you go.
Thank you.
your seat taken?
No, have a seat. You're hungry.
Yes.
Put the bag on the floor, okay? Under the table next to mine. And then when I leave, well, you know. So what's your name?
Sharonda.
Sharonda, that's a nice name. Sharonda, go ahead, you can eat. Sharonda, it was nice talking to you. Matt, you said it yourself. Ray wants Ordell. He doesn't give a shit about the money. The money won't convict him. Guns will.
You're rationalizing.
Well, that's what you do to go through with the shit you start. You rationalize. I can do it, Max. I know I can. I just can't do it without you.
Good work. She handles the cops, right? Good work.
What?
Jackie Brown.
I just want you to go out for a little while I work this deal. Oh, so now you go pop. Now it's gonna take 20 minutes, find a purse, look for a sandal, find a sunglasses, get out of here. Jackie. That chick you saw stomping around in the back there, that's Melanie who's about to leave. Have a good time there, baby. Don't burn her now. Okay.
No, I'm going to talk to you now, outside. Now.
In my office?
You got that we took the way I let out. We don't do it.
What
the hell are you talking about? You
know
I'm talking about?
She might have
somebody else.
No, she did.
Stop me at the airport and mark your bills.
Man, I don't like that part.
It washes off. Now, I tell them we do the same thing as before, and they'll follow Sharonda.
Yo, Louis, she ain't there? Yo, no answer? Now, you gotta listen to this, man, because this concerns you, all right? Okay, now, this time you're gonna get Sharonda a billing for the bag, right?
Right. The same one Simone gives me, okay? Now, Simone and I make the switch in Billingsley. She knows what I look like, right?
She seen you with Sharonda, remember? All right, now, Simone's gonna meet you in the dress department, right?
Right. Designer clothes.
Right. Place y'all try shit on.
It's a fitting room. Big sign over the door, you can't miss it.
Okay, well, why over there?
Because they're gonna be watching my ass hard. That's why we can't take the risk of doing it out in the open or even in the dining area. That's why we got to do it in the fitting room with a woman.
Okay, now, you're gonna take the Billingsley bag Simone gives you and give it to Sharonda. Okay, and Simone gonna wait, and she gonna peep out the dressing room, wait on you to give her the sign that ain't nobody watching. And she gonna leave the store, get in the car, mission
accomplished. See? So, when you gonna be doing all this?
Well, now that you got him watching my ass, I'm gonna be in a titty bar downtown waiting on Louis to call me, tell me everything's cool.
I got to go. Hey.
Damn, who doesn't want them paid up like that?
Straight
ETF guy. See, now that shit worked my nerves, you and that motherfucker being so buddy buddy.
Hey, if I wasn't so buddy buddy with that motherfucker, this wouldn't work. Adele has a bad weapon for handling Louis.
You two meet?
Yeah. This afternoon before I came here. He was at Odell's apartment in Hermosa Beach. Yeah. I don't know if he lives there, but I can find out.
You like him?
Not really.
His full name is Louis Carr. Just did 4 years up in Susanville.
For what?
Bank robbery. They've been following him. He definitely worked for Adele. They did 2 years together about 20 years ago or so. For Huntsville. He's not living over in Hermosa Beach, though. Ardell's got him staying down in Compton. He's living with some 56-year-old petty thief, some woman named Hawkins, Simone Hawkins. You know her?
No.
They ever talk about her?
Not yet.
Okay. Who's the other one?
Some white chick named Melanie, another girlfriend of Ordell's.
What's her deal?
That was her Kopeck I got busted with.
Oh, yeah?
She knows everything. She's not a part of it, and she's pissed off that she's not a part of it.
Well, there's definitely somebody I want to meet. Okay, we all set up for tomorrow? Everything okay?
Everything's the same except for one change. I told him Ordell's changed the amount he's bringing in.
Think they bought it?
Oh, yeah, I got him thinking that Ordell's real nervous, and they love thinking that he's scared of him.
You know, a good cop will never let you know that he knows you're full of shit.
Well, all he needed was a reasonable explanation. Right, everything's the same except for one change.
What's that?
Ordell feels way too hot for him to bring in his money. And he knows you're watching him, and he's fucking paranoid.
So he's sweating a little bit.
He's gonna keep his half mil where it is, but he's gonna bring in 50,000 just in case he needs bail.
It'll be more than that.
Oh, don't be so literal. Ray believed it.
You still have to show him the money at the airport.
Well, I'm not gonna show him the whole amount. He'll see 50,000.
And where's the rest of it?
In the bag underneath.
What if he checks?
He won't. He didn't before. He's expecting to see 50,000. And there it is on top.
You take a hell of a chance, kid.
Not really. If he finds it, I'll say Mr. Walker put it in there. And I didn't know anything about it, like the coke.
Well, then you're out. You get nothing.
Yeah, but I'm not in jail, and at least I tried.
You're gonna have surveillance all over you.
That's why you don't make a move until I come out of that fitting room.
Wearing a dress.
Well, a suit. This is one I had my eye on. You know, it's like... Excuse me.
Hello?
Look here, we got a little change in plans. No. Ain't no thing. You know, everything the same except one little difference. You know that bitch Simone you saw in the mall? Well, she wasn't here today because she done split on my ass. Yeah. Me and Lois went by a pad, she gone. She gone, her shit's gone, and my $10,000 motherfucking dollars is gone. Hey, don't start bugging on me, goddammit, I'm telling you, ain't nothing different. Everything just like we discussed. Now, except for this time when we make the split, instead of Simone, it's gonna be Melanie. Yeah, goddammit, Melanie got just as much sense as that bitch has. She be in the same fucking place, all right? All right.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna open it. I hope he's a good sailor.
Thank you.
Okay, the envelope contains $50,000. I've counted it, and I'm now marking the bills in the upper left-hand corner and the second zero with the green felt-tip pen.
Ever been tempted?
What? Put one of these in my pocket?
Mm-hmm.
If I did, I'd have to give one to you, wouldn't I? Of course, nobody knows how much there is. Guess we could take as much as we want. Isn't that right?
Yes, all those things are true.
I mean, it's not like the money belongs to anybody.
That would be one point of view.
Yeah. Except it's not a point of view shared by the ATF. Once we make this evidence, it belongs to us. You're officially out of trouble now. What about doing something stupid?
How can I do anything stupid when I'm being watched every second?
You know, I'm glad you pointed that out. Because it saves me the trouble of pointing it out to you. Now, look. Here's the deal. I want you to take all this cash. I want you to put it in this Billingsley shopping bag. And that is exactly what I expect to see when I look inside Sharonda's Billingsley shopping bag. Comprende?
Si, comprende.
Cool.
Hey, there's only three reasons you couldn't make your court appearance. One, you're in a hospital. Two, you're in jail. Three, your ass is dead. That means you're not my friend, man. Why are you
Winston?
Putting me in that kind of... Wait, hold on a second. Wait a minute.
I'm going to be gone for a few hours.
Where are you going?
Del Amo Mall, catch a movie, maybe something to eat.
What you going to see?
Something that starts soon and looks good.
Dude, have fun.
Let's go. You said that before. Let's go.
I'm waiting on high. I'm ready to go. Yeah.
Good morning, motherfucker, George.
Well, I might she keep saying in a minute, but.
Come on, man, grab that bitch by the head, drag her fucking ass out of there. That's my goddamn money.
I'll be the streetlight.
Suit. I'd like to try it on.
Wow, you look really cool.
Yeah. Hey, it looks cool on me, too.
It looks great.
I mean, you wear that suit to a business meeting and you'll be the badass in the room.
Yeah, I think I like it. I'll take it. I'm in a hurry. Can you ring it up for me?
Cash or charge?
Cash.
Melanie?
Jackie?
Hey, girl, what's up?
Hey, are you getting that suit?
Yeah, you like it?
Looks really good on you.
You got something for me?
You betcha.
Cherry on top.
Booyah.
What the fuck did Ordell ever do for us, huh?
Thanks.
Wear this suit instead of my title uniform.
Oh, that's right.
So, how much is it?
$267.
Wait, your change.
Oh,
by the
the way, someone left a bag of beach towels in the last bedroom.
Damn old lake. Come on.
Fuck!
Should have been there already. We would have been there if it hadn't been for you fucking around.
Jesus Christ, it's been 10 years.
Take it. Yeah, I'm in a hurry. Can you bring it up for me?
Cash or charge?
Cash.
It's a nice outfit on her. Let me go over and look at this Mitch and Mitch.
Just all right, fucking all right. Just stay right here.
Are you sweating?
Job a little too much for you? I want to be over there.
You just stay right here.
Because you're a little bit too conspicuous.
I don't care how conspicuous I am. Stay here.
Hey, would you let go?
Richard, what do you think?
Give me the bag.
He won't be carrying it.
Give me the bag.
What, you gonna rip the fucking bag?
Give me the bag. I'll knock your fuck up.
Okay, okay, take it. Jesus, what's wrong with
I'm
you?
I'm carrying the bag.
Yeah, right, you got it. Just take a chill pill.
Fuck
for Christ
you with your chill pill.
Remember where we came in? No, that's towards Sears.
Where the f- which way? Which way?
Jesus. But if you two aren't the biggest pair of fuck-ups I've ever met in my entire life, how did you ever rob a bank? Hey, when you rob banks, did you have to look for your car then, too? No wonder you went to jail. Is it this aisle you think? Is it? Sure.
Yeah, I'm sure.
You're positive? Don't seem sure to me.
Hey, don't say... Don't say anything else, okay? Keep your mouth shut.
Well...
I mean, don't say one fucking word, okay?
Okay, Lewis.
See? Just where I said it was.
Can I show you something?
Not right now. I'm just killing time waiting for my wife.
Oh, sure thing. Well, if anything grabs you, don't be shy.
I won't. Thanks.
Wow, you look really cool.
Yeah. Hey, it looks cool on me, too.
It looks great.
I mean, you wear that suit.
Straighten up, bitch.
I think I like it. I'll take it. I'm in a hurry. Can you ring it up for me? Cash or charge?
Cash.
Hey, would you let go? decided to wear the suit instead of my tired-old uniform.
No, that's no problem. I understand.
How much is it?
Okay, blouse.
And away we go.
Comes to $267.
Wait, your change! Oh, by the way, someone left a bag of beach towels in the last dressing room.
Excuse me? My wife thinks she left a bag of beach towels in the fitting room.
Yeah, I think they're there. Go get them. There's nobody in there.
Thanks.
Last stop.
Where all them car dealerships is, we gonna leave this heat from the parking lot and pick up a car the cops don't know nothing about. Where's Milton?
Well, that's what I want to tell you. You see, she was bugging me the whole time. She got pissy with me because I wouldn't let her carry the bag. And then she started running her fucking mouth about, you know, like, because I couldn't remember where the car was parked right away when we came out. So then she got on me about that. Is it this aisle, Lewis? Is it that aisle, Lewis? She's totally fucking with my nerves, man.
So what, you left her there?
I shot her.
You shot Melanie?
Twice. In the parking lot.
You couldn't talk to her?
Well, how can you talk to her? You know,
you couldn't just hear her?
Maybe, but at that moment, I don't know.
You shot her twice? Is she dead?
I pretty much.
What do you mean, pretty much, Lewis? There ain't no fucking answer. Yes or no? Is she dead?
I think so.
You think so? Tell me, Lewis. She's dead.
She's dead.
But where'd you shoot her?
In the chest and the stomach.
If he had to do it, then he had to do it, right? What we don't want is that bitch surviving on us. Not anybody but that woman. You light, ain't you? You light about $500,000.
Look, man, that's the bag she came out with. She never put a hand in it, neither did I.
Came out of where?
Out of the fitting room. It went down exactly the way it was supposed to.
How long was she in there?
A minute. Not even a minute. She came right out.
Oh, she's telling me the truth.
Listen, I swear to fucking God, man, I swear on my life, she came out with that fucking bag, and I took it from her.
And then what?
And that was it. We went to the parking lot.
Where you shot her.
That's right.
Lewis, we should have known you in a room somewhere to have $1 million. I worked my ass off to get waiting for you.
Fuck you for asking me that.
Yeah, I know the bitch tried to set me up.
You,
she didn't ask
you. Fuck you, brother. How could you fucking ask me that? Shit.
Call.
You ask her that.
All right, so where's the gun you shot her with?
It's in there. Well, what the fuck's that gonna tell you? I could have taken two out already.
It's Jackie Brown.
Well, you know, if she got it, well, why didn't she take it all?
Oh, I'd be sure and ask that bitch before I blow her brains out.
Well, maybe the feds got it.
See, if there wasn't nothing in that bag but them towels, then maybe she didn't get a chance to take the money out of her suitcase and the ATF got it. But she put them books in there to trick her ass.
Well, that's why I didn't check it, because the bag fell right.
That's right. And then she puts 40 grand or so in there to rub that shit in my face. You know what I'm saying? She wants me to know she ripped me off.
I don't know. Unless, you know, either she's got it or the feds got it.
Or, now check this out. What if she gave the money to somebody else first before Melanie even went in the dressing room?
Uh-huh. Oh, man, you know what?
What?
You know,
You know who I saw in a dress department?
No, tell me.
Man, I didn't think anything of it. No, I did wonder what he was doing there. I wondered what he was doing there, but I thought it had nothing to do with us. Like, maybe he's with his wife or his girlfriend. It's a big place.
Louis. You go tell me who you saw?
Yeah, Max Cherry.
You see Max Cherry in the dress department where we... Man, look at me when I'm talking to you. You see that motherfucker in the dress department when we about to get $500,000 and you don't think nothing about him being there?
Why? Do they know each other?
Hell yeah, they know each other. He bonded ass out of county.
Well, how am I supposed to know
you
that?
You know your bail bondsman, don't you? You know all them motherfuckers is crooked as a barrel of snakes, don't you?
Why should I think something's weird if I don't know nothing about them?
I don't want to hear no fucking excuses, man.
I ain't giving you fucking excuses, man. But I'm telling you, I'm giving you fucking reason.
Oh. You gonna tell me the reason you lost every goddamn cent I got in the world?
Hey, man.
You gonna tell me reasons?
You better...
Let me tell you the reason, motherfucker. The reason is, your ass ain't worth the shit more.
You better fucking back off, man.
What the fuck happened to you, man? Your ass used to be beautiful.
You didn't tell me you were going shopping.
I thought I did.
Yeah, you didn't. You know, if it's me, I got all that shit hanging over my head like you got hanging over yours. I don't know. I'd go shopping later.
I got there early. You see, I've had my eye on this suit that I wanted. Well, I'm just gonna go try it.
Wait a minute.
Just wait a minute. Just wait a fucking second, all right? Let me finish. I got there early. The idea was to try on the suit, see if I liked it. If I did, they would wrap it up, then I would put back on my uniform because Sharonda is expecting me to wear it. Meet Sharonda, give her the shopping bag with the $50,000, and go home.
Yeah, you didn't do that.
Because I couldn't. Ray, I swear, Melanie burst in, she grabbed the bag. And then somebody fucking killed her for it.
What in the bag she gave you?
She didn't give me a bag. Melanie was not a part of the plan. Odell probably told her to do it. That's why she came into the dressing room, grabbed the bag, took off, but I couldn't go after her because I was in my fucking underwear. I had to put on this suit because I could put it on faster than my uniform.
You had time to pay the sales check?
I had to. Ray, I was frantic. What was I supposed to do? I went looking for you. And I went back to the place in the mall where you were before, but you weren't there. What was I supposed to do if something happened? You didn't tell me how to do that, did you?
There's a guy with Melanie.
There was nobody in the fitting room.
Okay.
have no idea what happened to $50,000. You're clueless about the money, right? You have no idea what the 50 grand
is. I have no idea.
None. You
have
no idea. You don't know. It could have gone here. It could have gone here. You don't know.
I know nothing. Not a clue.
Not an
idea. I don't have an idea where the motherfucking money is.
Not even a little idea, maybe.
Not even a little tiny motherfucking idea.
You take a polygraph on
that. Yeah, if a motherfucker make you happy. Yeah, put it right there. I'll do it.
I sure hope you didn't do anything stupid, Jackie. I gotta talk to you for a second. Scar's dead. LAPD found her shot in the car at night. And we lost her down.
I thought you were fucking watching him.
We were. And we lost him. He walked into a strip bar sometime around 3:30. He never came out. Bar was on 9th, what, less than a mile and a half from where they found Lewis dead. Looks like Lewis's buddy shot him twice, point blank range.
So what's gonna happen now?
Pick up Ordell. We've got three murders we can link them to, and we got you.
What about me?
What about you?
You think I took some of that money?
Hey, I have no evidence of you doing anything. You didn't pay for that snazzy new suit with Mark Bills, but I'm about to see that. You've been helping us out. You gave us Melanie. You gave us Lewis. Melanie was found with a packet of Mark Bills stuffed in her shorts. That goes a long way backing up your story. I'll settle for a deal with Mark Bills. But if there's anything else you haven't told me about, you know what? That's between you and Ordell. I've got one thing to say. You better hope we find him before he finds you.
No, no, man, I done told you. I can't leave here tomorrow, Mr. Walker. I ain't going no goddamn way anyway till I get my motherfucking money. Come on, man, if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't have that motherfucking boat. Oh, yeah, right. I'm seeing who my friends are, motherfucker, right? Hello? Hello? Motherfucker hung up on me. You believe this shit? Ingrate, nigga. See? You bring a motherfucker up. Next thing you know, they breaking you off some goddamn disrespect. Motherfucker. Damn, girl, how you live like this?
Like what?
Like this. This some repugnant shit.
Bail bonds.
Yeah, Max there?
He ain't here right now, man.
But where he at? Out of town?
He's around, man.
Well, give me his home number.
No, I give you his beeper number.
All right, break off the beeper number, nigga.
Yeah. I've been looking for you. You know who this is? This is Mr. Roby, isn't it? I have your 10,000, that's why you called.
the bond collateral that you put down on Beaumont Livingston and moved over to Miss Brown, remember? Oh, she got off, did she? Decided to no-file this morning. Tell me where you are, I'll come give you your money. Still there? Look here, man. I know you helped her. And I know you know what I want. And Jackie can tell me any story comes into her pretty little head as long as at the end of that story she hands me my motherfucking money. And she want to be my friend, she do that. She don't want to be my friend no more. Well, you just tell her to think about old Beaumont. And if she go to the police, you tell her I will name her ass as my accessory. And we'll go upstate hand in handcuffed motherfucking hand. And that's a promise. You understand what I'm saying? You tell her that. And I'll call you back. You're right. That was Ardell. You have time. You think you could find out where he's staying for me?
Cops can't locate them, huh?
They don't have your winning personality.
Sure thing. I don't have to know what I'm doing, just as long as you know.
I think I do. Good enough?
Bet.
What's wrong with you knocking on the door like the goddamn police? You looking to get shot?
Thought you might be asleep.
You keep fucking with me, you the one gonna be asleep. Forever.
I'm alone.
Chess in the house. No, freeze, motherfucker. What you doing?
You want your money? Bond refund?
This all?
I have a receipt for it, son.
No, 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 motherfucker. You know what I mean. You talk to her?
She wants to give you your money. If she didn't, there'd be cops batter ramming your door down right now.
How'd you find me anyway?
Winston found you.
How'd he find me?
That's what he does. He finds people that don't want to be found.
Oh, what bully for that nigga. So she want to give me my money, huh?
Yeah. She wants to give it to herself. And she wants to collect the 10%. She also wants to explain why she had to hang on to it.
Oh, and I want to hear that shit, too. Turn around. Put your hands on your head. Why don't you tell me why?
Jackie didn't trust Melanie. She already tried to get Jackie to go in with her, split the $500,000 amongst themselves. What she did was take quite a risk to make sure you got your money.
And you helped her, didn't you?
All I did was walk out with it. Y'all went to all that trouble just to protect my interests. In a way, yes. My ass may be dumb, but I ain't no dumb ass. Go over there and sit on that couch. Don't worry about her. She don't even know you're here. Sit down. Those snakes. You get used to it. Where my money at? My office.
Where Jackie?
She's been there since Thursday night.
If she wants to talk to me, how come she wasn't home?
She's afraid.
Oh, right. That I gotta see.
She still is. She doesn't want to get shot before she can tell you what happened.
Well, tell her to bring the money over here.
It's in the safe. She can't get at it.
Call her and give her the combination.
Look, I'm telling you, you got her spooked. She won't leave there till you get your money and you're gone.
Oh, you expect me to just go walking in there?
If she wanted to set you up, you'd be in custody by now. When you told her that you'd name her as an accessory, that scared her more than anything. She believed you.
And that's why she wanted to give me my money, ain't it? It ain't got nothing to do with that bullshit about Melanie, huh? See, I ain't trust Melanie either, but I could handle her. That was my little blonde-haired surfer girl. I told that fucking Lewis all he had to do was hit her in the mouth, but no, he had to shoot her. Jackie's at your office, huh?
Huh?
She by herself? That big ass nigga named Winston ain't there, is he?
She's all alone.
All right. I call over there. She better answer the phone.
She will.
I'll be here. See you in a bit.
Time I'd known her, I ain't never heard her scared like that. Usually she too cool for school. Hold up, home. Give me the key. I'll drive.
Like the Delphonics. They're pretty good.
My money's in that office, right? She started giving me some bullshit about it. Ain't damn, we gotta go someplace else and get it. I'm gonna shoot you in the head right then and there. Then I'm gonna shoot that bitch in the kneecaps, find out where my goddamn money is. She gonna tell me to. Hey, look at me when I'm talking to you, motherfucker. Listen, I go walking in there, and that nigga Winston or anybody else is in there, you the first motherfucker get shot, you understand me?
Yeah.
That ain't nothing you want to tell me before we get out this car, is that?
Nope.
Last chance, motherfucker, you shot.
Hey, Jack. That's you?
Yeah.
God damn, girl. What you doing sitting up in here in the dark?
You dead?
Yeah, he's dead.
Does he have the marked bills on him?
He ought to have $40,000 in his pocket there and maybe another $10,000 I gave him.
Why'd you give him $10,000?
Return a bond collateral. I brought it to him so he wouldn't have to come here.
How'd you know where he was?
I found him.
What do you mean you found him?
That's my job.
You guys didn't tell the police?
I told Jackie. She said you wanted him.
Ray. Remember when you said you hope you get him before he gets me? You did. Thanks. Knock, knock. Hey.
Hey, you.
I got your package. It was fun getting $500,000 in the mail.
Less 10%.
Why'd you take so little?
It's my fee.
This isn't a bail bond, Max.
I hesitated taking that much.
But you earned it. Well, I'm leaving now, and, you know, I'm all packed up, ready to go.
That's our Dells.
They confiscated everything else. Registration was in the glove box. Keys were underneath the seat. Hey. What's the matter? Haven't you ever brought somebody's car before?
Not after they're dead.
I didn't use you, Max.
I didn't say you did.
And I never lied to you.
I know that.
We're partners.
I'm 56 years old. I can't blame anybody for anything I do.
Do you blame yourself for helping me?
No.
Look, I'd really feel a whole lot better if you took some more money.
You'll get over that. Where are you going?
Spain.
Madrid or Barcelona?
Madrid first. Have you been there?
I hear they don't eat dinner until midnight.
You want to go?
Thanks, but you have a good time.
You sure I can't twist your arm?
Thanks for saying that, but no.
You're scared of me.
A little bit.
I'll send you a postcard.
Will you?
I sure will, partner. Business, Max.
Jury bail bond. What is it your son's charged with? Yes. That's a very serious offense. Is your son still in school? Does his father still live in the house? Could I excuse myself? Would you call me back in about half an hour? Yes, thank you.
hell of a fight. Doing whatever I had to do to survive. I'm not saying what I did was alright. Trying to break out of the ghetto was a day-to-day fight. Being down so long, if nothing crossed my mind. But I knew there was a better way of life, and I was just trying to find. You don't know what you do till you put under pressure. Cross 110th Street is a hell of a tester. Across 110th Street, pimps try to cut your woman free. Get down.